Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. I received this comment from my viewer. Please make a video on SN74LS151 IC and what is its function. SN54 or SN74, starting number 54 or 74, both are same. This is commercial standard and this is military standard or industrial standard. It works on normal temperature and this number has wide range of temperature in minus and plus. After that, 151, that is standard. S151, LS151, 151A, HC151, HCT151, these all are from the same family. Function will remain same. There is difference between working frequency, power dissipation, propagation delay. Function is same. Might be 54LS151 will not work in the other place. Why? Due to its propagation delay, processing time. In simple words, processing time. How much time it will take from input to output. That is called processing time. It is 8 input multiplexer. What is multiplexer? If we see this switch, here is output terminal, common point. Then 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Forget 9th, we have 8 inputs. 8 inputs, 1 output. It is multiplexer. How it will work? Now this notch is parking at this open point, so it is not making connection with anyone. If I will shift to position number 1, now it is making connection with this one. So input coming from here will go out at this position. Now if I move this knob to position number 2, now first will open, any voltage level present at this pin will reach at output. Now third, fourth, just only one output which is selected from this knob will go out from the output pin. So we can select any input to be appeared at output. This is mechanical rotary switch. If I will say this is digital rotary switch working similar to this IC, that is right. I said we have 8 lines. And one output. Now this slider will move to any switch 1, 2, 3, 4 that is based on the selection. That input will be connected at output. This IC 8 line to 1 line multiplexer. But the best feature in this IC that it has two type of outputs. One is called true output, the second is called complement output. One is normal output, second is inverted output. If we check its pin out, pin number 16 VCC, that are chip biasing voltage. Pin number 8 is ground. S0, S1, S2, that are these three pins, 1, 2, 3 pins, pin number 9, 10, 11, these are selection pins. The same, we are selecting the rotary switch. These three pins are for selection. These will select number of input, which one we want to select at output. We can say here number 1, it is decimal position number 1. When we say digital, in digital it will use BCD number. S0, that is pin number 11. S1, that is pin number 10. S2, that is pin number 9. For position number 1, here it will select, because it is using BCD data, so position number 1, normally it will be called 0. I will write position number 1, that is equal to decimal number 0, 0, 0, 0. If all address selection are 0, it will select the first position, first input pin. So I0, that is pin number 4. I0, pin number 4. Pin number 4 will reach at output pin. Output is pin number 5. Y is pin number 5. That is true output. Then Y bar, that is pin number 6. If it is high, this one low. These are opposite to each other. Then there is an additional feature other than this rotary switch, that is enable pin. That is control pin. E bar. This bar means that if this pin will low that time, it will work. If it is high, it will lock the pin, it will disable the function. Let's start step by step. This IC needs 4.75 to 5.25 voltage DC because it is TTL IC. I will jumper positive with positive to bring rails upside and downside, common with common. Pin 16 is positive, pin 8 is ground voltage. For output, I will connect LED, resistor 1K, you can use 330, but 1K is good. LED small lead, ground lead will connect it to ground, that is cathode pin. We will connect one resistor in with anode pin. Second LED, one resistor, pin number 5, that is true output, it will go to this LED. This is pin number 5 and here is pin number 6. These are output pins. We will see outputs at these two LEDs. This is true output and this is complement output. Now I am connecting pin number 7. If you see its truth table, if E is high, at that time switch positions don't care. That means 9, 10, 11. These three pins are address selection pins. We need 5 volts. If I will connect this pin to positive voltage, Y bar or Z bar that is high. Sometime pin number 5 is known as Z, 6 is Z bar, or pin number 5 Y, 6 will W, or Y bar. We can see E is high, this is E pin, enable pin, enable is high, Z bar or Y bar, Y bar, Y is low, Y bar is high. Now we will select this pin to low, enable pin low, and all address selection will low. I0, input 0, that is pin number 4. Pin number 4 data will be transferred to Y output. Here is pin number 4. Pin number 4, if it is low, if I0 is low, Z is low. Z bar is high because it is inverted. And if it is high, that time Y is high, inverted output is low. Any logic available at input pin will be transferred to output pin. So position number 1 in case of 00, pin number 4 data will be transferred to pin number 5. Whatsoever, high or low, either it is 0 volt or 5 volt. When these all three inputs are low, just it will deal with pin number 4. Same here, we selected one position, it will pass just only this voltage. It has no concern with other pins. Same here. Now it is dealing with pin number 4. When we will select address number 1, just only one pin high, that is S0, pin number 11 high. Now it will not deal with pin number 4. It will deal now with pin number 3. Any data that is available at pin number 3 will be transferred to output. If it is low, true output, pin number 5 is low, second is high. If input is high, that time Y is high or Z is high. What is name in the data sheet? In this data sheet it is showing Y. In this data sheet it is showing Z. In some data sheets, Y and W. 0, 0, 1. Pin number 3 data will go to Y. This will opposite. If pin number 3 is low, this will high. This is pin number 5 and this is pin number 6. We selected address 0, 0, 1. At that time, pin number 3 is transferring data in the output. In this condition, if enable pin is high, now it is changing data, low to high. But if enable pin is high, now it is locked. It will not respond to any input signal. To take output, we need to pull down enable signal. Now position number 2, that is 010. S1, pin number 10 will high. Now it will deal with pin number 2. Same, if enable is high, it will lock. Now the third position, 011, it will deal with pin number 1. If data is low, Y is low, Y bar is high. Now next position, 100, these two are low now and this is logic high. Now it will deal with pin number 15. Low, low. High, high. At that position, the data present at this specific pin, which address is selected, that will go in the output. Now 101. Same as I was discussing, that when we will select any position, data present at specific that pin will go at output. Now I selected position pin number 14. Yes, low, high. When we selected 101, now we are dealing with pin number 14. After 101, there is condition 110. Now we will deal with pin number 13. Yes, 110, 9 and 10 high, 11 low, 9, that is this high, high, and blue is low, 110, we will deal with pin number 13. Output will switch any data, it is high or low, it will shift it at output. So it is multiplexer. If all inputs are high, at that time last output, pin number 12, will select it. Here it will not deal with pin number 13, because we selected the position number, pin number 12. Now data present at pin number 12 will transfer that output. Either it is low, either it is high. So this is the function of this IC. Anytime if enable pin is turned on high, this IC is disabled. If it is enabled, it will respond to signal. We select input position. What is address selection? At that time, that specific pin will appear at the output pin. If you think this video is informative for you, then you can like it. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.